I've talked about this idea of the Holy Spirit as a dove everywhere that I go since I've been back. College chapel, seminary chapel, in my classes. Just finished a 7-week class on prayer and the Holy Spirit with folks from a number of different churches. It was fun. And God sent me a little love note on this. That's the only way I can describe this.
Sometimes all we have to hold on to is what we know is true of who you are. So when the heartache hits like a hurricane, that could never change who you are. And we trust in who you are.
What Satan fears most is not the occasional conversion or the good things we do in Jesus' name. What he fears is that we'll discover that we're supposed to be in an army and begin to act like it.
Lord, we know your ways and not our ways. So we set our faith in who you are. And even though you reign high above us, tenderly love us, we know your heart, and we rest in who you are. Even if the healing doesn't come, life falls apart, and dreams are still undone. You are God, you are good.
The Holy Spirit is God's mouthpiece to believers. When God speaks directly to you, it'll be through the Holy Spirit. Living inside us, He has direct access to our minds, our emotions, and our conscience.
You're still the great and mighty one. We trust you always. You work in all things for our good. We'll sing your praise.
You think that encouraged me to keep praying? Listen, if you're on my prayer list, the only way you're going to get off is if you ask to get off or you're dead. Those are the only options. He taught me something there. He assured me that I was doing the right thing. He reminded me that it was the correct thing. And he reminded me also that he was paying attention to me and I needed to pay attention to him.
Even if the healing doesn't come, and life falls apart, and dreams are still undone. You are God, you are good.
Church look like if we started praying all out with passion? Partnering with God in prayer, asking the Holy Spirit to put needs on our heart, and when he did, never giving up. Making biblical promises real to us. Sharing then with each other when God answers in miraculous ways. Keeping track of our prayers and their answers. Recognizing desperate situations as opportunities to exercise faith and having your faith grow as God answers. Praying with forethought. Remembering who we're praying to. Letting the emotion and desperateness of the need grip us, not just reciting a list. Crying and stretching out on your face for those needs only God can take care of. Taking a stand in spiritual battles against Satan in our prayer life. Expecting God to answer and praising with the same level of passion as our prayers.